Welcome to part two of the Making a Game in HypeHype tutorial series. In this part, we're going to be looking at objects and how do they work? Let's find out. So let's open our draft that we were working on in the previous video, and we're going to head on over to the asset library. Now, the asset library has a ton of different assets for you to use in your games. When you first enter the asset library, it's going to show you a number of different featured assets that we currently have. But you can use the tabs at the top to search through different types of assets, or you can use the search function if you're looking for something more specific. Now, if you're following along, you can select any asset you like. I'm gonna choose these gold ingots. We already looked at the widget in the last video, so you should be somewhat familiar with this, but it includes move, rotate, and scale options. But speaking of moving objects, let's take a look at our different snapping modes. So from the quick menu on the left, we can take a look at the different snapping options. Free movement allows you to move the object however you wish. Snap to edges will snap the edge of your object to the edge of other objects. This is great for getting the same sized objects to fit together perfectly. Snap to grid will snap objects to a grid based on world coordinates. This is great for keeping things perfectly spaced or organized. If the object has physical properties, then the physical collision snapping mode allows for an object to be moved freely, but it will collide with any other physical objects. This is good for placing things so they don't clip with other objects. The final option here is specifically for logic nodes. By default, nodes snap to the grid, but this can be disabled when you want to move them freely. And that's it for snapping. Now let's talk details. When an object is selected, its details panel will appear in the top right corner. If it's collapsed, you can tap on the two bars to open it up, or you can tap them again to collapse this. Now, the details panel has two tabs. We have the basic tab and we have the advanced tab. At the top of the basic tab, you can see a preview of the object you've selected, and you can tap this to open up the asset library, and from here, if you want to, you can replace it with any other asset. So for example, this is new, this is cool. Let's take this wizard. So by tapping the plus icon on the wizard, we can replace it with the wizard. Oh, big wizard. Let me just rescale that. There we go. Below the preview, we have the visual material properties. And depending on the object, you will see between 1 to 4 colored spheres here, and they represent the visual materials that are used on the object. You can tap them to select different materials. So for example, I can make this red color. Let's make it purple instead. Now, if none of the materials are what you're looking for, you can also tap edit here on the right, and you can then edit any material that you would like to. So if I want to play around with how this purple looks, I can change it from around here. Let's make it like a lighter purple. Visual materials are a resource that are shared by all of the objects within a game, so just be careful when you're editing a specific material. It'll change for every object that's using that material within the game. You can also make a completely new material by tapping on the plus icon next to edit. If you're not familiar with these terms, no sweat at all, just play around with them until you get something that you like. You can also just learn by playing around with them and figuring out what each of them kind of does. So if I want to make like a HypeHype green right here, of course, pull it up right here. The emissive, you got to be careful with. It makes the object very shiny. Now, before we finish, we should name this material. Let's call it HypeHype green, or just HypeHype. We all know what color that is. So after you've named it, you can just type select and your new color will be applied to your object. Next, in the basic details panel, we can change the physics type of the object. No physics means the object has no physical properties. It can be seen, but not touched. An unmovable object has a physical body, so other physical objects can collide with it, but as the name suggests, it cannot be moved with physical forces. A dynamic object can be moved by physics, so it can be pushed around by other objects, thrown around by forces like explosions, or get pulled to the ground by gravity, commonly known as falling. Below physics, you can tap transform to expand the transform tab. Here, you can also move, scale, and rotate your object by changing the corresponding values. These are good for using if you want to be really, really precise with how you are placing your objects. So maybe you want the object to be at an exact world coordinate, so we moved it to 5. Or you want to rotate it to a perfect 45 degree angle, like this. So like I mentioned, those settings are really good for if you want to be really precise. We'll get into the behaviors in a later video, so for now, let's switch on over to the Advanced tab. The Advanced tab is where we can access any nodes that have been attached to this object. And any object, for example, with a visual model is going to have a visual node attached to it. You can tap on the node to expand it. Now, if the object is set to unmovable or a dynamic object, it's also going to have a physical properties node. Now, the physical node has a lot of different properties, so for now, let's just have a look at physical materials. Physical materials define things like the density of your object, how quickly it can move, and things like how much gravity affects it. And like visual materials, these are a shared resource by all of the objects in your game. You can tap here on the Physical Material tab to select the type of material that you want the object to use. From this menu, you can also edit or create new materials, just like we did with the visual ones. Now, when editing or creating a new physical material, we have some different options this time. For most creators, the Basic tab is going to hold most of the features that you want to edit. On the left side, we have density, bounciness, and friction. These determine how heavy the object is, how much the object bounces around, and how much it slides. On the right, we have movement slowing and turning slowing. These settings adjust how quickly an object will slow down once it's in motion, and also how much force is required to move it. In the additional panel, you can change how much gravity affects your object, and also its sleep thresholds. Dynamic objects in HypeHype will go to sleep if they are not moving. This basically makes them unmovable objects until they come into contact with another dynamic object or a physical force. And these settings determine at what speed that sleep occurs. In the Advanced menu, there are, well, advanced settings. If these all sound like complete Martian to you, there's no need to worry. You most likely will not need these unless you want to get really, really deep into physics someday. Okay, so just to make some changes to the basic material, I'm gonna put the bounciness way up, and we are going to name it again. Something really creative, like bouncy bounce. There we go. Oh, spelled it wrong. And then select, and that's now being applied to the object. Finally, all objects have an object node, and to the right of that is the plus icon, where we can add more logic nodes to the object, but we're gonna cover more of that in later videos. The last thing we're going to look at today is the bottom toolbar. Almost everything you need to create your game can be found from the bottom toolbar, including the visual and the physical materials that we just went through. You can find the visual materials by tapping on colors, and the physical ones are in physics. And this is just another way to navigate to the materials menus when you want to edit or create new materials. So that's going to be it for this video, but before we wrap up, let's save our project by tapping save on the top right. And then you can tap save again at the bottom to save all of the changes that we have made to our draft. Next time, we're going to be taking our first look at premades, as well as adding a playable character to your scene, and also an introduction to the game camera. That's all from me this time. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you in the next one. Oh my god, I'm amazing! I said it right first time! It helps that I have filmed this video 3 times. Now, below the preview are the visual material properties. Next, in the basic panel, we can change... When you first enter the asset library, it's going to show you a number... Dude, this word is not wording in my head! Featured. They are featured. Featured assets. Featured. Okay. But speaking of moving an object, let's take a closer look at the snapping modules. Modules? What? Modes! Obviously modes! I'm sorry, what on earth? Where did this word come from? Yeah, today is not my best kind of filming day, as you can maybe tell, so I am just going to read these, and we will cut to a different scene. Okay.